This is the big bamboo so many begged for, the H2S. It's bigger, way cheaper, and at the same time, a little boring? No dual nozzle tricks and further limitations, just raw print volume. But is that a smart move or a trap compared to the Creality K2 Plus? Let's find out today at 24/7 Printing. When the H2D came out, the community was loud. We don't want dual nozzle experiments, just give us a bigger X1 carbon at a fair price. And here it is, the Bamboo Lab H2S. $1,249 for the base, $4,099 with AMS, and $2,099 for the full laser combo. That's what I've been testing for the past weeks, thanks to Bamboo Lab for sending it over. A single nozzle tool head similar to the approved A1, and the build space being now at 340x320x340, everything just as we already knew from the leaks, right? All the other designating specs, quite the same as H2D. So, thanks for watching, servus and bye bye. No, wait, there's a bit more to it. Though there's really not too much to talk about the H2S, so this video will be an ADHD compliant quick one, just like the videos I like watching. We check out all the differences compared to the H2D. There are important decisions to be made carefully before ordering. Also, we elaborate on how it stacks up to the Creality K2 Plus. That part will be very exciting, as MSRP of H2S and K2 Plus happen to be exactly the same. Two quick disclaimers. First, even though I got and show the laser version, I focus on the printing part for this video. I'll check out the laser part of this machine in another one. Second disclaimer, as H2S and H2D are very close in specs and performance, just watch my in-deep comparison video on the H2D versus K2 Plus and Prusa XL afterwards. It has detailed chapters, so you can jump just to what you're interested in. Pricing is where the H2S makes a statement. It's $750 cheaper than the H2D base and $800 less for the AMS or laser combo. That's huge. But there are trade-offs. The H2S has no 40-watt laser option and you can't upgrade it to dual nozzle H2D later. Not because of technical limitations, Bamboo simply doesn't want that path open. You need to decide up front. That's a pity in my opinion. Look at Prusa. They let you upgrade from a simple Batzlinger to a full Core XY machine. At least you can turn the H2S into an H2S laser, if you really want that, with all the same cutting and drawing features as the H2D laser. Again, except for the 40-watt path. Apart from that, the core specs remain the same. 350 degrees Celsius nozzle, 120 degrees Celsius bed, and a 65 degrees Celsius actively heated chamber. I'll skip the full unboxing show. Others do that anyway, and honestly, it's almost identical to the H2D. What matters? It was safely packed, I managed to set it up alone despite the weight, and calibration plus first print were quick and painless. Even with the laser version, there was nothing tricky here. That just worked. Yeah, no, boring, right? Let's talk about design. The H2S cut some of the premium details for the H2D. No more glass side panels or glowing bamboo logos. I like the glass on the H2D because it made the build space brighter, but that's one of the trade-offs for the lower price. The tool head follows the same logic. Gun is the second nozzle, the swivel mechanism, and the dedicated nozzle camera. You still get the side-mounted camera, and the rest is identical to the H2D. Same nozzle options, including the high-flow variant, same servo extruder, same heat-up times. The upside of simplifying the toolhead? A bit more build space. 340 instead of 325mm in X, and 340 instead of 325mm in Z. The print bed is basically identical to the H2D. Same PEI sheets, same hardware, just without the extra nozzle offset calibration. What stands out is the heat-up speed. Still blazing fast, and honestly one of the things I appreciate most about the H2 series. But there's also a limitation. When set to 120 degrees Celsius, the surface only reaches about 104 degrees Celsius. And the temperature distribution isn't perfect either. On paper, that sounds bad. But in practice, the first layers came out consistently good, even on full bad prints. The actively heated chamber helps here, compensating for the lower surface temps. I didn't retest chamber heat up because it's the same design as the H2D with only slightly lower max power draw, likely just from having one hot end less. The display is unchanged from the H2D. Still a great and responsive UI, but the hinge hasn't improved. It feels wobbly when you tap on it, and it gives a bit of a cheap impression. Electronics, software, filtration, no surprises here. It's identical to the H2D, which means you get the full H2 feature set with no cuts for the lower price. If you want a dive deep into details, I already covered all of that in my big H2D video. The viewers liked it to dive deep there. By the way, are you subscribed? Now's a good chance to do so. Thank you. So let's skip straight to the part that really matters, the printing. But first, quick pause, because while we're about to check the printing performance, the video is powered by our partner that might actually help with your projects, PCBWay. Besides PCBs and assembly, PCBWay also offers 3D printing and CNC machining, with impressive variety of materials and processes. You can prototype in plastics, metals, resins, or even flexible rubbers. Whether you're testing fit, form, or function, there's a process for it. FDM, SLA, SLS, MJF, CNC milling, turning, the list goes on. Link is in the description. Check out PCBWay's rapid prototyping options. Multi-material is where the H2S shows its limits. Without the second nozzle from the H2D, you're stuck with a single path, which means every filament swap goes through the same nozzle. Yes, you can daisy chain multiple AMS units and print with a dozen of colors if you want, but trust me, the waste and the times are brutal. Take the Deadpool bust. It looks good at first glance, but the white parts show bleeding, and compared to the H2D or a proper tool changer like the upcoming U1, the time and waste go through the roof. I even pushed it further with a crazy test. A CRT scan of a lower leg, mixing PLA bones, PETG support interface, and TPU joints. It printed, but the TPU joints snapped and the PETG basically melted into the PLA. At that point, I gave up. This is not a multi-material printer. Forcing PLA, PETG, and TPU through one nozzle? Bad idea. Period. When it comes to single color printing, the H2S is exactly what you want. Boringly reliable. Every test I threw at it just worked. The KSR FDM benchmark, clean results. The Voronoi Deer in PETG, good retraction performance. Even TPU with lots of retractions printed fine, not quite as clean as the Prusa XL, but still impressive for such a tricky material. On high temp materials, it was the same story. A full plate of ABS Voron parts with a flawless first layer. A quick Mandalorian helmet in ABS-X. A PACF stealth burner front. On the H2D, I successfully mixed ABS supports with PPSCF parts. A great way to save money and still get nice break-off supports. But on the H2S, I didn't even try. Pushing ABS and PPSCF through a single nozzle is just asking for trouble. That's where the dual nozzle system of the H2D makes sense. With the H2S, stick to a single material only. Comparing the slicer settings for speeds and accelerations for bamboos and closed printers, there are only slight differences. For instance, on H2S, only the inner perimeter is printed at a bit of higher acceleration than H2S. You won't see drastic differences in print times, also compared to X1C or P1S. So let's talk about flaws, and yes, there are a few. First, some generic filament profiles are still missing in the slicer and printer. For instance, no ABS out of the box, which I expect Bamboo will fix with updates. Second, spaghetti detection. On my TPU CAD print, it kept triggering from stringing, so I had to turn it off. And third, filament pileup. Every multi-filament print ended with a mess at the purge chute. The new wiping station on the H2S just couldn't handle it. The good news? The chamber camera reliably spotted all the pileups before they could kill a print. So the problems are real, but at least they don't get unnoticed. One quick note on noise before we wrap it up. Overall, the H2S is just as quiet as the H2D. The only difference, the new nozzle wiping station. It makes a noticeable clatter when purging filament. Not a deal breaker, but you will hear it. Alright, the H2S is exactly what you'd expect. Bigger, cheaper, but also a bit more restricted. You save $750 to $800 compared to the H2D, and you still get the full Bamboo ecosystem. Quality, convenience, but also the usual restrictions. No upgrade path through the H2D, no 40-watt laser, closed firmware. If you can live with that, it's a fantastic fire-and-forget printer, from PLA to TPU to PPSCF or PPACF. Not the fastest, not the largest, but probably the most convenient printing experience at this price. So who should go for the Creality K2 Plus instead? If you want a bit more build space, slightly higher speeds, and the freedom of clipper configs, the K2 Plus is tempting, but the trade-off is rough edges, weaker profiles, less polish, and lower reliability. The fact that Bamboo priced the H2S at the exact MSRP tells you a lot. They see Creality as the real competition, as they come closer concerning product experience. And honestly, I think the H2S is the stronger product at the same price, but that's me. Now I want to hear from you. Is this the big Bamboo you were waiting for? Or do you prefer open source freedom and a cheaper entry point? Or maybe you think single nozzle printing is already dead and it's all about dual nozzles and tool changers? Let me know in the comments, I'll be reading. If you found this helpful, drop a like, subscribe and comment the heck out of this video. Big stuff is coming up next on 24/7 Printing. Servus and bye bye! Thank you, Shuno!